हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस व्हिच इज क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. एंड इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस द टॉपिक व्हाट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. वी डिस्कस the concept of quadratic equation and its general form of the quadratic equation, and also we discussing the roots of the quadratic equation. We discussing the roots of the quadratic equation and how many roots of the quadratic equations, and we also discussed about the relationship between the roots and the coefficient of the quadratic equation, and we take the question based on the factorizations and simplification based question related to that chapter. Now, dear friends, in today's class, we take and solve some important questions related to the chapter quadratic equation. So let's see some important question. And the question is, solve the following quadratic equation. Solve the following quadratic equation by factorization method. Solve the following quadratic equation by factorization method. And your question is 1 upon a plus b plus c plus x is equal to 1 upon a plus 1 upon b plus 1 upon x in such a way a plus b is not equal to 0. Okay, this is a very important question related to your chapter quadratic equation. So what I do for that, dear student, let's see its solution. First of all, given we have a plus b plus c plus x is equal to 1 upon a plus 1 upon b plus 1 upon x. Okay, now look, first of all we collecting the like terms, means we separate the variables, we take together the terms of x. Solving the quadratic equation means what? We finding the variables which is involved in that chapter, in that question. So now we can write as a plus b plus c plus x, one by x transfer that side, that is 1 upon x is equal to 1 upon a plus 1 upon b is left. Now we take the LCM in both side of the relation. Look, so here we take the LCM x into a plus b plus c plus x, and right side we take the LCM as a into b. Here, now here that is b plus a is left. Now here this one cancel to each other. So here we get what, x into 1, that is x minus xx cancel to each other. So we get a plus b plus c plus x in this way. Okay dear students, now look. Now we break the bracket, so x minus a minus b minus c minus x होल अपॉन एक्स इंटू ए प्लस बी प्लस सी प्लस एक्स इज इक्वल टू दैट इज ए प्लस बी अपॉन ए बी. नाउ हियर एक्स एक्स कैंसल टू ईच अदर. नाउ व्हाट आई डू डू नाउ वी डू दियर क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन. तो वी टेक माइनस एस कॉमन and okay dear students, where c is term here? No, this is a plus b plus c x only. Here this question is wrong. Here this is a plus b plus x only is there, plus x only is there. Okay, so here a plus b plus x is only. Okay, this is plus x. Okay, and a minus b minus x. So minus x term cancel to each other, so we get minus, take s common. So if we take minus s common, dear friends, from the numerator, so we get a plus b, okay, upon this is x into a plus b plus x, x into a plus b plus x is equal to, in right side is equal to a plus b upon a b. Now what I do? Now we do the cross multiplication. So we get minus AB in bracket A plus B is equal to A plus B into X into A plus B plus X. Now we separate minus AB or we transfer that side. So look, X into A plus B into A plus B plus X. And this is plus AB in bracket A plus B is equal to 0. Now from these two terms we take A plus B as common. Okay, so if we take A plus B as common, so we get X into A plus B plus X plus AB is equal to 0. But we know that implies that A plus B is not equal to 0. Okay, now we take X in bracket A plus B plus X plus AB is equal to 0. Okay, now look that side. Now we multiply them. So this is ax plus bx plus x square plus ab is equal to 0. Now we take these two terms. So x is common. So a plus x is left. Now from these two terms, we take b as common. So this is a plus x is equal to 0. So this is common one. So we take a plus x in another bracket x plus b is equal to 0. When we take this is equal to 0 and this is equal to 0. So when we take x plus a is equal to 0, so that is x is equal to minus a. And when we take x plus b is equal to, then x is equal to minus b. So these are two solution answer of the given question. So in this way, dear friend, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exam based on this show. Now we take and solve some other important question related to that chapter. Let's see. question. We have very important question. Solve. The given equation is 1 upon x minus 2. Solve the expression 1 upon x minus 2 plus 2 upon x minus 1. 2 upon x minus 1 is equal to 6 upon x. Is equal to 6 upon x. Dear friend, this is a very important question of your syllabus. Let's see its solution. So, dear student, in that type of question, dear student, in that type of question, first of all, we take their LCM. We take their LCM. Let's see. So, let's see its solution. We take the LCM is what? X minus 2 into x minus 1 and is equal to 6 by x is right as it is. 6 by x is right as it is. Okay, now look. So here we take both the LCM. So now look, if you're dividing again, so x minus 2 cancel to each other. So we get x minus 1 multiplied by 1, that is x minus 1 plus x. When we divide, so x minus 1 cancel to each other. That is x minus 2 into 2, that is 2 into x minus 1. So we get this. Now we simplify here. So we get that is x minus 1, that is plus 2x plus minus minus 2 on the 2 upon. Now that is we multiply again, that is x square minus x minus 2x plus 2 is equal to 6 by x respectively. Now look. That is 2x plus x, both are the like terms, so we adding them. So we get what? This is 3x and minus 2 minus 1, that is minus 3 upon this is what? X square minus this is 3x plus 2 plus 2. Okay. Is equal to 6 by x. Now what I do, we take 3 as common from the numerator. So this is x minus 1 is left upon that is x square minus 3x plus 1 is equal to 6 upon x. So now 3 to the 6. Now what I do, now we do the cross multiplication, dear students. So look, that is 2 into 2 into x square minus 3x plus 1, okay, is equal to x into, that is x minus 1, x into x minus 1, okay. Now we simplify them. Let's see. So look, we multiply them. So 2 into x square, that is 2x square minus 2 3 is, this is 6x plus 2. Is equal to, this is x square minus x. Now we transfer that side. So that is 2x square plus x square, transfer that side, that is minus x square minus 6x right as it is, minus x transfer that side, that is plus x plus 2 is equal to 0. Now that is 1x square is left and here minus x plus x, that is what, minus 5x. Minus 5x, okay. And plus 2 is equal to 0, okay. Now we do their factorizations, okay, by the method of splitting the middle term. Now look, this is 2, 1, 2. Now look, that is 2 into x minus 2 is there. Oh, one is mistaken here. X minus 2 is left there, dear students. So that is 2x minus 2 is 2 2's are this is here 4. Okay, here one mistake is there. So look. From there, students, here this is what? This is 2 now, 2 2's are 4 is left here. So we have this, look, this is 3x minus 3, 4, 1, 4, 1, that is minus 5 upon this is x square minus, that is 3x plus 2 is equal to, that is 6 upon x. Now we do their cross multiplication, so we get, look, 6x square minus 6, 3 is 18x plus 6, 2 is 12 is equal to, that is 3x square minus 5x. Now we collect the like terms, so this is 6x square, this is minus 3x square, minus 18x, and here minus 5x, transfer that side to plus 5x, and plus 12 is equal to 0. Now look, this 3x square minus 3, see this is 3x square is left, minus 12x minus 5x, that is minus 13x, minus 13x, minus 13x, and plus 12 is equal to 0. Now look, we do their factorization by the method of splitting the middle term. Okay, so let's see. So that 12 3 is 36, 9 4. So this is 3x square by minus 9x minus 4x plus 12 is equal to 0. Now we group the terms, pairing from pair. So we take 3x as common. Here this is x minus 3, 3 is x minus 3 is that here. And minus 4 take common. So that is x minus plus minus 4 3. So now look, now what I do, now we take x minus 3 whole common, in second bracket this is 3x minus 4 is left, is equal to 0. Now when we take x minus 3 is equal to 0, that is x is equal to plus 3, this is first answer, when we take 3x minus 4 is equal to 0, that is f4 upon 3. This is the second one.
So in this way, dear students, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on this topic. This is one of the most important question of your syllabus. So please dear students, do more and more practices of that type of questions. Now dear students, we take and solve some other important questions based on these topics. Let's see. And the question is, solve the quadratic equation. Question is, solve the quadratic equation. This is under root 3x square plus 10x plus 10x plus 7 under root 3 is equal to 0. Under root 3x square plus 10x plus 7 under root 3 is equal to 0. So what I do for that question, dear friends? This is a very interesting question, and we do their factorization by the method of splitting the middle term. So by the method of splitting the middle term, first of all, we do the multiplication of last term, constant term, and in the coefficient of x square here. Under root 3 into 7 under root 3, that is 21. Now we do the prime factorization of 21. So after doing the prime factorization of 21, we get what? 73 is, let's see, 73 is the prime factorization of the 21. So now if we split the middle terms 10x, so we take two terms. To take two terms by these two, okay, by the prime factorization of 21. So now thus we can write root 3x square plus 7x plus 3x plus 7 root 3 is equal to 0. Okay, so we split the middle terms. Okay, now let's see one more term, important term, step. So now we can write as 3x square plus 7x plus, we can write this 3 as root 3 into root 3, and x write as it is, plus 7 root 3 is equal to 0. Okay, now what I do, dear students, now we take the common from the pairing of terms. Now from these two terms, we take x as common. And now from these two terms, we take under root 3 as common. So now, here, look, x is common. So root 3x left in first term plus 7 is left in the second term. 7 is left in the second term. Now here, from these two terms, we take root 3 is common, na? So we get root 3x in first term, root 3x left in the first term, na? Plus, this is 7 in the equal to 0 second term. Now look, now there are two terms, 1 and 1, second one. Now, from these two terms, we take root 3x plus 7 as common to whole term. So, we get x plus root 3 is equal to 0. Now, when we take this is equal to 0, one time we take this is equal to 0. So one value of x is what? This is minus 7 upon root 3. And when we take this is equal to 0, so x is equal to minus root 3. So this is the required solution of the given question. So in, dear students, in this way, you can solve that type of question. Okay, these are the very important questions of your syllabus.